she had internal injuries and lacerations of major organs, and so she didn't survive.
A vicious dog killed her pet over the weekend in Des Moines, and if it is caught, this vicious pet would automatically be destroyed. Good evening, everyone. A change in city law will give some vicious dogs a second chance.
News Channel 8's Todd Magel just back from City Hall with the story tonight. Todd?
Well, vicious dogs that attack will still be put to sleep, but dogs who are considered vicious just by breed alone and who then violate city code will no longer face automatic euthanasia.
The dog was so powerful, and the little boy couldn't do anything either. You know, he was screaming at the dog to stop.
Nancy Roberson lost her best friend Sunday night. She was walking her 10-year-old Shih Tzu named Zoe in front of her North Side home. That's when another dog attacked and killed Zoe. It's 30 seconds she'll never forget.
Just went after her and picked her up in his teeth and mouth and shook her around. And it was only, I mean, maybe 30 seconds, but I rushed her to the hospital, and, you know, it was too severe. We were just right here in the front yard.
Roberson says a 10-year-old boy was walking what looked like a pit bull, and the boy lost control of the animal. Now she can't find the boy or the dog.
I asked the little boy where he lived, and he said it was none of my business.
If the dog is found, it faces impounding and euthanasia.
That won't change. What will change is that now if a vicious dog is found without insurance or without a license, it won't automatically be put down. Instead, the city will send it to the Animal Rescue League.
The Animal Rescue League would then evaluate the vicious dog and determine if it's right for adoption with a new family, a family that would agree to license and insure the dog.
Should the dogs be put to sleep because of irresponsible pet owners? Yeah, I don't think so. And I think a lot of other people feel that way, too.
The city council feels that way and unanimously voted to amend the vicious dog ordinance.
It was not the dog. It was the owners.
But Nancy Roberson is not convinced about giving some vicious dogs a break.
I feel very strongly that these dogs just don't belong in family homes and in neighborhoods.
Kathy Roberson lives near Beaver and Hickman, and she says if you see any blonde pit bull-like dog that weighs about 60 to 80 pounds, please call police. They say it may be the one that they're after.
And Todd, when does the change to this ordinance take effect?
Right away. The council passed all three readings tonight.
Okay, Todd, thank you. Now, this issue is sparking a lot of debate on KCCI's U Local. Here's what people are saying. Quote, if they can be rehabilitated by professionals, then why not? Maybe they didn't get a fair start in life, but now they have a chance to be someone's true friend and companion. Another writes, the real problem are the people who abuse them or teach them to be mean. These people should be charged with a crime and should not be allowed to own or have pets in their custody. But this person says, quote, I love dogs tremendously. However, I am definitely for putting vicious dogs down. Vicious to me are dogs that have bitten humans or attacked other animals. Dozens of pages of comments on this issue. Let us know what you think at KCCI.com. Just click on U Local.